kids! It's me, Miss Tina. This week's lesson is going to sound very familiar as last week's lesson. And that's because it's going to be a repeat. That's right, Jesus raised Lazarus. We're going to review it again. Now, this is not a mistake. There's two reasons why we're going to go over this lesson again. I want you to understand what the big picture of this story really is. That it's not just about Lazarus coming back to life, but rather it's about the power that Jesus has over death. And reason number two, I heard that some of you like to play a game of trying to guess where I'm filming from when you watch the video. And I thought that that was just so cool. So I had to refilm this week. Okay, kids, so if you didn't get a chance to watch last week's lesson, then you should really go back and check it out before you watch this one. There are some really important things, and I don't want you to miss them. Stay with me here, because in just a minute, we're going to watch our video, Jesus Raised Lazarus. But first, I want to play a little game with you. Okay, the game we're going to play is called Emotion Charades. So, I'm going to act out some emotions, and what I want you to do is try to guess the name of that emotion that I'm acting out before I tell you. Okay, are you ready? Here we go. Did you guess it? That's right. I'm happy or I'm laughing. I have so much excitement. Okay, here's the next one for you. Can you guess that one? Yeah, I'm mad, angry, or upset. All right, I have another one for you. See if you can get this one. Did you guess that one? I'm nervous or I'm anxious. Okay, one more. Okay, did you guess that one? You're right. I was sad. And in today's story, we're going to hear about a time that Jesus was sad and he even wept. Let's check it out.
Jesus and Lazarus were friends. Lazarus lived in the town of Bethany in Judea with his sisters Mary and Martha. One day, Lazarus got sick. Mary and Martha sent a message to Jesus. "Lord, your friend Lazarus is sick," they said. Jesus told his disciples, "Lazarus' sickness will not end in death. This sickness will bring glory to God and to the Son of God." Jesus stayed where he was for two more days. Then Jesus said, "Let's go back to Judea." By the time Jesus arrived in Bethany, Lazarus had been in a tomb for 4 days. Martha hurried to meet Jesus, but Mary stayed home. Martha said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died." Martha knew Jesus could do a miracle, though. "I know God will give you whatever you ask," she said. Jesus replied, "Your brother will rise again." Martha believed that Lazarus would rise from the dead in the future on the last day. But Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me, even if he dies, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die, ever. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," Martha said. "I believe you are the Messiah, the Son of God." Martha went back to her house. She told Mary that Jesus wanted to see her. So Mary left the house, and all the people who had come to comfort Mary and Martha followed her. Mary fell at Jesus' feet and said, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Mary was crying. Jesus wept too. Mary led Jesus to the tomb where Lazarus was buried. It was a cave and a huge stone covered the opening. "Remove the stone," Jesus said. So the stone was moved aside. Jesus looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you heard me." Then Jesus shouted, "Lazarus, come out!" Lazarus came out of the tomb, wrapped in linen and cloth. Jesus said, "Unwrap him and let him go." When Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead, he showed that he has power over death. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." Jesus died on the cross for our sins and rose from the dead. He gives eternal life to those who trust in him.
What a cool story. Jesus is never wrong, and everything he says is perfect and true. Lazarus' sickness didn't end in death, because Jesus has power over death. Now that's what I want you to see here, kids. This story is not just about Lazarus coming back to life, and even though that's pretty cool and all, the main point of the story that I hope you understand is that Jesus has power over sin and death. Jesus defeated death and took away sin's power when he died on the cross and then rose himself from the grave. It's because of Jesus that we have the same power living inside of us. Do you know what that power is? That's right, it's the Holy Spirit. And we can tap into that power and defeat sin and death too. Everyone who believes in Jesus and the truth about him will gain life with God forever. Isn't that awesome? Okay, that's a lot of talk about life and death and death and life. So let's turn the page now and let's do something fun. We're gonna play a game, and this is even something that you can do at home with your family. Okay, kids, are you ready to play our game? We're gonna play Wrap Up Lazarus. And all you're gonna need is a couple rolls of toilet paper, a Lazarus, that's gonna be me, and a couple players. All right, really cool thing about this game before we get started is that you can use this to explain today's story to your family and tell them how this game relates to today's story and everything that you have learned. All right, what you're gonna need to do is make sure your players have their toilet paper, okay? You set a timer for 1 minute. And players, you have 1 minute to wrap up Lazarus as much as you can before your timer goes off. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, ready, set, go! Hurry, wrapping! Oh no!
Oh no!
Good job, keep going!
Yeah, we're going! We've got this!
And you're going!
I'll go down here!
Keep going, wrap me up like Lazarus!
It's like... I wonder how much time we have left.
Okay. And 10.
Ah!
9. 8.
Ah!
7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Time's up. Okay. Toilet paper down. All right. Do you remember what Jesus said after Lazarus came out of the tomb? He said, "Unwrap him. Let him go." Can you unwrap me, boys?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Ah! I hope we can get all this off. See you next week. Bye.